In this video, we're going to take a look at the derivation of a trig reduction formula. So here's the reduction formula we're going to look at specifically. We have the integral of sine to the n of x dx. And the reason this is called a reduction formula is because it takes this integral of sine to the n and it gives us an integral of sine to the n minus 2, you'll see here at the end of the formula. So I've reduced the power of the sine in my integral. So how did they come up with this formula? Well, it's a little complicated, but I'm going to show you the steps here just because it's pretty interesting. So we're just going to start with the integral of sine to the n of x dx and see if we can make our way back to this formula. So the first step we're actually going to do is integration by parts. So I'm going to let u equal sine of x to the n minus 1 power. And I'm going to let dv equal sine of x dx. And this might seem like a strange choice, and it is, but it'll make things work out for us in the end. Now, let me just verify for you that u times dv is going to give me back my original integrand. So u, I'm letting equal sine of x to the n minus 1, and then times dv, which is sine of x dx. Okay, sine of x to the n minus 1 times sine of x is sine of x to the n power, or as we had it written before, sine to the n of x dx. So we see that these parts are valid. So let's go ahead and proceed and compute du and v. So to compute du, I'm going to need to calculate the derivative of u, which is why I rewrote sine to the n minus 1 in this way instead of the original notation we had here. So what I'm going to want to do is use the power rule here combined with the chain rule. So I'm going to bring this power of n minus 1 down, and then I'm going to have sine of x to the n minus 2 power, but then the chain rule says I need to multiply by cosine of x dx. Okay, and then I also want to compute v, which is just going to be the integral of sine of x dx. Okay, and that's going to give us negative cosine of x plus c technically, but we will let c equal 0 for now. So we know that integration by parts tells us that the integral of u dv equals uv minus the integral of v du. So let's go ahead and apply that using the parts we just came up with to the integral of sine to the n power of x dx. Okay, so uv is going to give us negative cosine x times sine of x to the n minus 1 power. Then minus v du, that's going to give me minus a negative, so I'm going to go ahead and write that as plus. And we're going to have an integral here. And in my du, I have this factor of n minus 1. That's a constant with respect to the integral, so I'm going to go ahead and pull that out front. And then inside my integral, I'm going to have a sine of x to the n minus 2 power times a cosine squared x dx. All right, so we've made some progress here. The next thing we're going to do is use a trig identity to help us rewrite this expression a little bit. So recall that cosine squared of x is 1 minus sine squared of x. That comes from one of the Pythagorean trig identities. So then we can use that to rewrite part of this integral, and we'll get the following. And now, inside my integral, I am going to go ahead and expand this. So when I distribute the sine x to the n minus 2 power, I'm going to multiply it by 1 first of all, and then when I multiply it by sine squared of x, I'm just going to get sine of x to the n power. Now as my next step, I'm going to break apart this integral, which has two terms subtracted. I'm just going to write that as two separate integrals. And notice also in this step that I've gone ahead and switched back to the other notation for powers of sine here. Both of these notations, for example, here and here, are completely equivalent. I'm just kind of going back and forth based on what's more convenient for me at the time. All right, so what I have to notice next is I need to notice that on the right-hand side, I have this term which involves the integral of sine to the n of x. And then I also have on the left-hand side a term with the integral of sine to the n of x. So I'm going to combine those by moving this whole term on the right-hand side over to the left, just by addition. So to both sides, I'm going to add a factor of n minus 1 times the integral of sine to the n of x dx. Now on the left-hand side, I'm adding one factor to n minus 1 factors. So overall, that's just going to leave me with n factors. And then, of course, on the right-hand side, I'm subtracting and adding the same thing, so those are going to cancel. So I end up with the following. So you may be able to see what my last step should be. To isolate this integral of sine to the n of x, I'm going to simply divide both sides by n. And then with just a little bit of rearranging, we get the reduction formula we saw in the beginning.